What is this internet craze called planking? What's that about? It's come under fire, apparently, from the Victoria Police. Do you know what it is?
Well, I think it's where you balance on your inner core, your solar plexus, either on a very narrow protrusion or a long, slender pole.
Like a plank.
Like a plank, like Nadia Comaneci does on the uneven bars, not the uneven bars.
So the body's the plank, apparently.
No, the body's not the plank.
Apparently.
Oh, it would be, yes, because you've got to be as firm as a plank.
Police have warned that dangerous stunts will not be tolerated and that planking on roads or public transport was dangerous and against the law.
It's the breathtaking moment that shocked Australia. Sam Newman preparing for perhaps his dumbest stunt yet. On a balcony overlooking Melbourne's Docklands, the AFL Footy Show star climbs onto the railing 46 stories high and planks. With news choppers in the air, cameras on the ground, Newman lies horizontally across the corner of the balcony rails, as he bragged he would do only hours before on a popular radio program. Planking is surely one of the most ridiculous crazes we've seen. It involves simply lying flat on the ground or on an object. But the more publicity it's got, the more extreme it's become.
We want to get the message out there to be safe and think before you plank.
It wasn't Sam's first attempt at planking. He's demonstrated his dubious talent before, much closer to the ground. But there's nothing funny or clever about this latest exploit. It doesn't bother Sam that everybody, from the Prime Minister down, reckons this kind of behaviour is not only dangerous, but it also sets an extremely bad example for millions of young Australians.
Acton fell to his death while planking from the seventh floor of this Kangaroo Point high-rise yesterday morning.
The AFL footy star Sam Newman has denied that there was anything dangerous about a planking stunt that he recently performed himself. The TV personality was filmed dangling on the balcony of his 40-storey apartment just hours before Queensland man Acton Beale fell to his death performing a similar stunt. So not a good look, Wendy.
Not at all. And despite the dangers, this craze is not dying out down at all.
This is the photograph that has Nate Shaw in so much trouble.
I thought I'd do one with a bit of risk and do a cop car.
It's called planking, the latest Gen Y craze to sweep the world. Lie face down, stiff as a board, arms by your side, and do it in the strangest of places. Get someone to take a photo and slap it on the net. That's how police found Nate. He posted the shot on Facebook.
I know they're doing their job, but I don't really see the problem with a few guys having a bit of fun, really. It's not hurting anyone, haven't caused any damage, not breaking anything.
The 20-year-old will appear in court later this month on the obscure charge of being found on a police establishment without lawful excuse.
It's just a laugh, you know, don't take yourselves too seriously.
Josh Macbeth has been planking for about a week, says planking is hardly an extreme sport. Applicants are judged on degree of difficulty and where they do it.
It's a bit of fun.
Not everyone can see the funny side of planking. The police say it's downright dangerous and someone could get hurt.
In some cases, it's hard to disagree. Take this shot, for example, or this one of a man planking on a speed bump.
The whole point of it is a joke.
I want to become the best planker there is.
What do we know about this victim?
Well, Wendy, we know that the 20-year-old man was drinking with mates when their fun turned ugly. His friends have told police that he was planking on the top of a mate's car when he went speeding off and put his foot down. Now, of course, that caused the victim to go flying off the back of the car and slam head first into the cement. He's now in an induced coma in Newcastle's John Hunter Hospital with critical head injuries. His brothers are by his side, but obviously, Wendy, this is a very anxious wait for this family as they wait to see the full extent of his injuries, and they're praying today he will in fact pull through. No, it's not. Police here today have said that they're fed up with this behaviour. They're fed up of having to respond to such irresponsible behaviour, and they say that, of course, it can end up in very dangerous conditions with a young man, in this case in hospital, in a coma with critical head injuries. Let's have a listen to what police had to say a little earlier.
Police and the emergency services in the area are dumbfounded that we continue to attend these accidents. I think it's fair enough to say that, you know, enough's enough.
The message from police here, Wendy, is clear that the few minutes of fame that people get from planking on the internet is simply not worth it.